Hey, how's it going, everybody? YouTube's Explic91 doing a little commentary on how to beat Challenge 300 on the Challenge Tower for Mortal Kombat. I've seen a lot of people do like videos on how they beat it, but I didn't really see anyone doing like commentary. They just like explained it in a rough view. So I'm just gonna show you what I roughly did in like a little mentality of how I had it all set up. So for this specific challenge, I actually did agree with most of them to use Scorpion. Again, a lot of people use different people, but I actually forced myself to learn Scorpion just for this challenge because it's actually really easy with Scorpion. All right, so let's get this started, and I'll try to explain it the best I can while watching the replay. So basically, with Goro, you just really have to just throw his spear the whole time. I do the follow-up combo with the two punch and follow-up with the kick, and it pretty much does his damage a lot of times. You might be wondering why it may look really easy right now. Well, supposedly, from what I understand, if you lose a certain amount of times, the computer kind of dumbs down a bit and you get a little recovery boost on, but you have to lose a certain amount of times. I lost like 10 times trying to figure out this stupid puzzle. I mean, not really puzzle, but like, the strategy. But as you can see with Goro, all I have to do is spam the spear and then go ahead with the combo because he really doesn't have much to offer. And you'll notice that I'll get a recovery boost after that. I'm not sure if it's the same for PS3. I'm not sure if you have to lose a certain amount of time for the PS3 as well, but it should be the same concept. But again, you can leave it in the comments if I'm really not sure. So with Kentaro or Wotaro, whatever his name is, him, you have to be really careful because he loves to spam those fireballs. Again, it's roughly the same concept with Goro, but when he teleports to the sky, time it about 2 seconds before you jump up and do a kick. Because if you time it wrong, if you jump ahead of him, like before he drops down, he will hit you before you hit him. So just make sure you time that. You'll notice that I went ahead and immediately went to the X-ray to do more damage because with him, you can't mess around with him. So again, just usually follow the strategy how I have it set up because you just spam the spears. If he starts throwing fireballs, go ahead and go close to him and go for an overhead kick. Because once he has a when he starts throwing fireballs, he gets like an extra damage boost. So, but he should be pretty easy. Now, Melina, I see so many complaints about Melina that she's the hardest one, but to me, she's the easiest one. All you have to do is crouch and block, and just uppercut. That's all it is. Crouch, block, uppercut. You'll see me just do that the whole time, and she'll just fall for it every time. I tried it multiple times to confirm it, and it works almost all the time. So, you guys shouldn't have any issues with Melina at all. Just the one you should have issues with is Kentaro and Shao Kahn. So you'll see me take out Melina really fast. So just watch it a bit. Again, just uppercut, uppercut. That's all she really needs to take her down. She actually catches me with her X-ray, and I was actually surprised. But with that little bonus health that I get because I lost so many times, I kind of get full bar already. So now Shao Kahn. Shao Kahn's actually the really hardest one to go against because he might be easy to some of you, but for you, for those who really don't know, spamming the spears really won't work against him. But you'll see, like early on, I kind of mess up a bit. But the real strategy against him is when you go up for a cross up, which is basically jumping behind him, don't go for a kick. You'll see me do that a couple times because I really messed up. But then I started understanding his strategy. Don't go for a kick when you go behind him. Once you go behind him, immediately follow up with a spear because he'll be in the process of doing a move. Then just rinse and repeat. Just keep on doing the same thing as you see me doing it right now. So once you jump behind him, follow up with the spear, and you'll pretty much have a three-hit combo. So you don't have to worry about him attacking you. Of course, he'll take some hits from him, so you have to be wor like pay attention to that. You could use your X-ray if you have a chance to use it. I think I follow with the X-ray once I have a chance. And remember, don't be too nervous about it. Just don't lose your groove, and just wait till he makes one mistake when you jump behind him, then follow up with the spear, and you should get him like just about every time. So don't worry about that. So I'm pretty sure you'll get this. I have a tutorial linked up to how to get fast coins if you just want to skip through all the challenges to buy Challenge 300, which is what I did. Because I really don't want to play all the challenges. I only played the test your might, test your sight, and all that stuff. So I didn't really want to go through all the challenges, but I will go through it later on. I just want to do a little quick tutorial for you guys, and hopefully this was helpful. And yeah, you guys, just leave a comment, rate it, And I'll leave a link to the next video of how to get fast coins to level up faster. So again, thanks for watching this video. This is Explic91 and I'm out. Late.